Good morning, friends. Does Scripture contradict Scripture? This morning we're at Jeremiah 7, verses 21 through 27. Thus says the Lord of hosts, the God of Israel, add your burnt offerings to your sacrifices and eat meat. For I did not speak to your fathers or command them in the day that I brought them out of the land of Egypt concerning burnt offerings or sacrifices. But this is what I commanded them, saying, obey my voice, and I will be your God, and you shall be my people, and walk in all the ways that I have commanded you, that it may be well with you. Yet they did not obey or incline their ear, but followed the counsels and the dictates of their evil hearts, and went backward and not forward. Since the day that your fathers came out of the land of Egypt until this day, I have even sent to you all my servants, the prophets, daily rising up early and sending them. Yet they did not obey me or incline their ear, but stiffened their neck. They did worse than their fathers. Therefore, you shall speak all these words to them, but they will not obey you. You shall also call to them, but they will not answer you. Well, we can begin here. Scripture, of course, does not contradict Scripture. Some people want to interpret the Bible literally all the time in every place. And what we really want to do is we want to interpret the Scripture according to the intended meaning of the author. So many times the authors use things and we use them ourselves day by day. They use metaphors, ironies. There's a whole range of, you know, poetry, different kinds of expression that are used. And so a lot of those aren't quite exactly just literal. So we want to let the author speak the way he intends to speak. Let us seek for the meaning that the author intends, not one that we're going to impose on the text by saying the whole Bible is all literal. It's not all literal. So what's going on here? Because now I can show you the text. You can show me the text. God did command his people when they came out to do certain sacrifices and offerings. He did command them to do that. Here he says, I did not command you to do that. Something wrong here? No, I don't think so. So what is God really telling them at verse 22? Well, one thing is, he wants their obedience. He doesn't want their sacrifice. Obedience is, yes, better than sacrifice. And so we start by knowing that's God's will. The sacrificial system was instituted by God. It was valid. He gave them that. Was the sacrificial system for a bunch of fakes to just, you know, toss some sacrifices into the fire? No, of course it wasn't about that. God wasn't for that. God instituted this for people who want to be rid of sin, who want to come to him. That's what the sacrificial system is for. To just go through the rituals and bring these sacrifices when your heart is far from him, what use would that be? And God basically tells them, by the way, if you bring the sacrifice, you might as well just go ahead and eat the whole thing because it's not going to mean anything to me. I won't be accepting it. If you come to me and your heart is closed and you're really not concerned about your sin, your sacrifice isn't going to mean anything. I won't be addressing it in any way, shape, or form the way you want me to. God is not mocked, and so we know that he's not fooled. He doesn't go in for any of this fake stuff. And what effect would a sacrifice have for somebody whose heart really isn't in it? Of course, no effect at all. So it's not doing anything for anybody. You know, they could be going forward, but the people described here are going backwards. And then for us today, are we going forward? Are we really advancing spiritually? Or are we going backward? Are we being kind of sucked down back into the sewer of this anti-God culture that's all around us? Is that maybe more of what's happening sometimes in the church than actually us going forward? So here's a question. Is there anything that you're doing today that's kind of like an open in your face, you know, open, we're out in the open having a picnic kind of idolatry thing? So the kingdom of Judah was doing it all their own way, and they were kind of one of these, you know, 100 miles an hour into the brick wall kind of attitude going on. May we understand the uselessness of a fake faith and give him all of our hearts. Let's pray together. Dear Father in heaven, help our hearts to be open to you. Help us to find the bread of life, Jesus. Lord, help us to receive the nourishment you have in the Bible. Thank you for hearing our prayer request. In Jesus' name, amen. Scripture does not contradict Scripture, but sometimes people contradict God. On that note, have a wonderful day serving the true God of heaven and earth.